as a man is being led to a stake where he'll be bound and burned until he's finally dead. He sees where they are taking him, yet his mind is made up still. He knows this is the only fire that he'll ever have to fear. His mind goes back to why he has to pay this awful price. Someone had given him a Bible, and he had given God his life. He believed its words, rejecting all the evil church's lies. And it was for his love of that great book he was gonna burn alive. So why can't we stand up for what they died for? Their every dream we take for granted every day. The world is lost without the gospel message. Let's stay true to this book as it leads the way. The man's wife stands in silence as his hands are being tied. His life would soon be taken right before her very eyes. Oh, but suddenly her faith grows strong. She's ready now to die. So she cries as they begin the fire, if he goes so alive. I can see the wicked council as they watch those dying men. This Christian faith cannot last long with such cruel torment. But the executioners found out there was nothing they could do. You see, the more they persecuted them, the more the number grew. So why can't we stand up for what they died for? Their every dream we take for granted every day. The world is lost without the gospel message. Let's stay true to this book as it leads the way. Well, in this world we're living, God's word is second choice. Other books and commentaries seem to have a stronger voice. But we must realize God's not finished with his precious written word. So it's up to you and I to make sure that his voice is heard. So why can't we stand up for what they died for? Their every dream we take for granted every day. The world is lost without the gospel message. Let's stay true to this book as it leads the way. Let's stay true to this book as it leads the way.